Only one remaining problem, and that is the devil. He's the accuser of the brethren. He's our adversary. And there he is, I say, ever ready to bring us into condemnation. How do you deal with the devil, my friends? And this is where people today are so superficial, it seems to me, they don't know the devil. We are not ignorant of his devices, says Paul, and the more one goes on in this life, the more one gets to know about the devil. And I've sometimes suggested that a test of whether a man is a true Christian or not today is to ask him, do you believe in the devil? For if he doesn't believe in the devil, I don't think he believes in God. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, says Paul, that's bad enough, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high or in heavenly places. There is the opposition, headed up by the devil. How do you answer him? And you can't answer him except in these terms, the new and living way. You know how you do it? This is how it's put in the scriptures. A word says in the book of Revelation, they overcame him. How? By the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. That's the only way to settle the devil and to silence him. Tell him that Christ has died for you and he's speechless. He'll argue with you to his heart's content and he'll beat you at your arguments. But you mention the blood of Christ to him. Tell him that Christ has died for you and he'll give it up. He can't say anything. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. I shall my fierce accuser face and tell him, thou hast died. My dear friends, this is our only hope at a time such as this. The arm of flesh will fail us. We dare not trust our own. The battle against us is so mighty. It's so furious. The forces against us are so strong. We have but one hope, and that is in the Lord and the power of his might, clothed with his armor, and praying over it all, that the armor may be kept clean and bright. Pray without ceasing, and then we shall have our victory, that men should always pray and not faint. We shall not faint, on condition that we hold fast, as he goes on to say, let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering. Yes, but don't forget the prayer. Prayer is absolutely essential. And this is the only way in which it is possible. Let us therefore go and come with boldness into the holiest of all, by the blood of Jesus, this glorious, new, and living way. Go to him in full assurance of faith, and he'll hear you, and he'll answer you, and he'll make you more than conqueror.